We want to find the four smallest positive radian solutions to the trig equation cosecant 4 theta minus 4 equals 0. So for the first step, we'll isolate the trig function. So we'll add 4 to both sides of the equation. So this will give us cosecant 4 theta equals 4. Now we could leave this equation in terms of cosecant, but I think it would be easier if we solve this using the sine function instead. And since cosecant and sine are reciprocals of one another, if cosecant 4 theta is equal to 4 over 1, this means that sine 4 theta would equal 1/4, which is reciprocal of 4 over 1. So we'll solve this equation instead of the given equation, and the solutions will be the same. Next, we do want to perform a substitution for 4 theta. We're going to let u equal 4 theta, which means we'll solve the equation sine u equals 1/4. And then once we find u, we'll come back and determine the values of theta. We're looking at this equation here. If u equals 4 theta, then we divide both sides by 4. Theta is equal to u divided by 4. So we can't forget that our ultimate goal is to solve this equation for theta. So once we find u, we'll have to come back and find theta. So now to solve the equation sine u equals 1/4, we should recognize that we won't find sine function values of 1/4 by using the unit circle or from reference triangles, which means we'll have to use the calculator to help us solve this equation. But one thing we should recognize is that if the sine function value here is positive, and we know that sine theta is equal to y divided by r, this is telling us that the y coordinate must be positive, and therefore our solutions must occur in the first and second quadrants where the y coordinate is positive, and therefore the sine function value is positive. And now before we go to the calculator, if sine u equals 1/4, if we solve this equation for u, we would have u equals inverse sine or arcsine of 1/4. So this is what we'll type into the calculator to help us find our first solution. We first need to verify that we are in radian mode. So we'll press the mode key. We are in radian mode. So we'll go back to the home screen. We'll type in second sine 1/4. And because we're asked to round theta to 3 decimal places, we're actually going to round our solutions in terms of u to 4 decimal places to avoid any rounding errors. So our first solution for u is approximately 0.2527 radians. So we'll call this u sub 1. Now let's go ahead and sketch this angle in the first quadrant. Again, this angle is approximately 0.2527 radians. But because the sine function value is also positive in the second quadrant, if we sketch a 0.2527 reference angle in the second quadrant, we can find a second solution. So we found this angle on the calculator, and this angle here will also have the same sine function value. To determine this angle, we could take pi radians, half a rotation counterclockwise, subtract this reference angle to determine our second solution. So again, u sub 2 is going to be equal to pi minus 0.2527. Let's go ahead and change these to approximation symbols. So now we'll go back to the calculator. Pi minus 0.2527. So our second solution for u is approximately 2.8889. Remember, we're asked to find the four smallest positive radian solutions. So we found the first two in terms of u. The next two solutions will be coterminal with our first two solutions. So the next solution in terms of u would be the angle that starts here as one complete rotation and then stops here, which would be 2 pi radians plus 0.2527. Which is approximately 6.5359. And now for our fourth solution, this will be coterminal with the angle in the second quadrant, which would be 2 pi radians plus 2.8889. or the angle that starts here, one complete rotation, and then stops here, which is approximately 9.1721 radians. But now keep in mind we're not done. These are our solutions in terms of u, but the original equation was in terms of theta. So now we have to go back and find theta, where theta is equal to u divided by 4. So we'll go ahead and do this on the next slide. So we started with the substitution u equals 4 theta, and therefore theta equals u divided by 4. We found these four values for u, so then to find theta, we'll take each of these values and divide by 4. So let's go ahead and do that. 0.2527 divided by 4. Now we were asked to round to 3 decimal places, so we'll round this to approximately 0.063. Next we have 2.8889 divided by 4. So we have approximately 0.722 radians. Next we have 6.5359 divided by 4. Which is approximately 1.634 radians. And then finally we have 9.1721 divided by 4. Which is approximately 2.293 radians.
These are the four smallest positive radian solutions to the original trig equation.
Which, remember, was cosecant 4 theta equals 4. So these angles would satisfy this equation, even though we use the equation sine 4 theta equals 1/4 to find them. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.